Hello guys, our talk today will be about social engineer and how we're gonna exploit it through improvisation. Okay, our agenda today, as we can see, we have some facts and tips, hacking the mind. We're gonna know how to attack human behavior. Also, we're gonna use micro expression and its effectiveness through social engineer, story time, and the last thing, the mitigation. The famous who am I today? I'm a penetration testing specialist and security researcher at DTS Solution, a company based in Dubai. I have like 8 years experience doing pen testing, social engineer, physical assessment, like oil and gas companies, government, educational institutions. I have wrote tools, Xasia, which is cross-site scripting tool, and Pitworm, you can easily find in GitHub. I'm certified a lot of things, but doesn't make any difference. Big hunter in my spare time, and sometimes coding malicious stuff, but just for me. So we always know that the layer number 8, which is human, is the most vulnerable, in my opinion, and it can't be patched. We all know that. No CVEs, unfortunately. There are many definitions out there. You can find a lot of definitions. What is social engineer? I believe most of you know what is social engineer. Simply, it's a physiological manipulation of people in order to gain information. Using this information in a bad way or a good way is depending on your intent. It's a very old attack vector, but techniques being innovated by time. Also, the malicious codes. We know the attack vectors, it's like chat, text, person, phishing mails, right? It's low investment, high return of information, and causing a lot of damage. So this is like a fact. In 2014, is like study. They asked like some 200 senior level IT security professionals what the most dangerous attacks. 37% of them saying the phishing and social engineer, 24 for malware, and 32 for public phishing applications. And here's another one in 2016, surveys like 500 IT security professionals, and saying like 81% in USA saying the social engineer, and Europe saying like 83%. So ransomware and phishing mails are friends. They are truly good friends, right? So I'm going to show a video. This video is created by Cisco. I don't make any advertisement for them, but it's a real nice video how see if ransomware and phishing mails are really good friends.
Me. Yeah. I just spy on people and see what makes them click. It's not a bad job.
Okay, here's the video finally.
How did you decide to become a hacker?
Well, I'm not really sure what it means to become a hacker. That's like some guy in a hoodie who types really fast and stays up all night writing code and cracking passwords. It's not me. I just spy on people and see what makes them click. It's not a bad job.
Mark Hanning, CEO of Qualicard, set to report earnings after their blockbuster IP.
So you consider this a job?
I put a lot of work into this. I'm not lazy. It takes research to figure out the key players, learn all about them, their families, their friends, what they care about. You have to understand the company's organization. I get a lot of my information from the sales department because they're always so quick and eager. They're hungry. People trust too easily. They don't look at the details. I do. Details matter. That's what I'm good at. It has to look completely believable. It has to look familiar. This is where research is important. It's not some generic piece of spam. It's an email from their boss with their company's signature. It's written in the voice of the boss. It's what he would say if he were writing this.
What about the malware itself? How does that work?
Somebody else out there already wrote all the code that does the actual attack. I'm just using it in the attachment. My skill is in my ability to get a bunch of people to click on that attachment. I always wonder what it's like when the whole thing unfolds on their end, when the panic sets in.
Please leave your message after the beep.
Hey, this is Rajiv in finance. Call me as soon as you get this. Something's up with my laptop. I can't.
Katie, are you on your way into the office? Something's going on with our file servers.
The Karen in HR, our benefits dashboard seems really slow. We're getting calls from users on it.
Apparently, there's a malware attack targeting our main...
It's ransomware. They're holding us hostage.
We're locked out of everything. I can't even check my phone. What about the backup?
That will take days.
We need this fixed now. Just pay it. We don't have a choice. We're reporting earnings in 2 hours.
But how do we know
that
they'll...
Just pay it. Put every single person on getting us back up and running. That's the only priority now.
Okay, it's done.
I have the decrypt key.
The ransomware was just to distract us. They got inside. They got everything. Customer data, financials, everything.
Qualicards is reeling today from the news that hackers have released the personal information of nearly 2 million.
The Nasdaq closed lower today, led by Qualicard, which was down 14% on news that their recent data breach may be far worse than the company originally
announced. Its stock fell to a new all-time low on news that CEO Mark Hanning is stepping down after what is turning out to be one of the worst breaches of personal information in recent history.
Do you feel bad about releasing the personal information? All the financials? All the money that was lost?
All I did was get the files. I'm not the one that decided to release them.
How did you decide to become a hacker?
Okay. So, as you can see in the video, how the ransomware is very bad. It's causing a lot of damage. Many of companies has lost millions of dollars. Many people may be saying that the worst thing happened to the company is ransomware, which is true. But in the end, ransomware need a phishing mail or some distraction to get to the company. I mean, it's like one of the techniques social engineer is to get the ransomware. It's not delivered by itself, right? So this is a simple, typical ransomware phishing mail with a doc file attached. The doc file has embedded VB macro that is used to grab second stage payload, most often the ransomware itself. So, just like human mind, we always know that human minds has gaps by default. If you think you are not vulnerable because you are not a stupid person, think again, please. In my opinion, stupidity does not exist. Maybe some person have a lot of knowledge more than another person, and another person have a faster response more than another person. So, in my opinion, there is no something called stupid. Social engineer is more than getting inside the company, stealing a laptop and get it out. I can steal maybe some laptops here and get it out. It's not social engineer, right? And phishing mail is not pretending to be a king of Persia, offering $1 million. This is crap. So social engineers target what? They target trust. Essentially, the most important thing to establish trust between you and the target, right? And a target helpfulness. People like to help. All the people like to help. Or getting help, right? False assumptions. Not every gentleman is a gentleman. Maybe I'm wearing a suit and tie, I'm going to the company, pick up anything and get it out. Security guard say, I don't think he's a thief. He don't look like a thief. Curiosity. Human nature always like to know what behind our galaxy. It's like If I drop like some flash drives inside your organization, your curiosity is like pick up one of these flash drives and put it in your computer. If you're gonna format it, it's worthless. Fear, we're talking about fake authority. It can be used a lot of many people that you pretend that you have the authority to harm someone if he didn't let you get inside the organization. And because of fear, he let you in. Ignorance, that many people didn't know the existence of social engineer. Sympathy, which is the most one I like, that makes the target feel sorry about you. When the target feels sorry about you, he will do everything to help you. Micro-expression is very useful for social engineer. Required to have some skills to understand body and eye contact language. Every culture has own expressions, right? Expressions for Indian people, different from USA, different from Middle East. We are able to understand your country expression only. Maybe like, for example, Indian have like a movement head sign of he agree or disagree with your talk, right? But there is universal expression we are going to learn about. I will not talk deeply about this. It's like the anger, fear, happiness, sadness. And you can find more about micro expression through this link. Many of us know how to understand micro expressions. I mean, it's easy to, if someone is happy, you can easily know he's happy or sad. You can understand signs of happiness and fear, but you never know why. Maybe he's sad because he have a fight with his wife or something. It's not about your talk, right? You think about his job, maybe he's in stress. My focus relating now on how to use micro suppression. I use micro suppression to get more information from the target. When you use fear and sympathy, you should select the perfect level. Please avoid overreacting. It's like you don't want to, if you want to use sympathy, for example, and let's say you're going to an organization and you forget to print your CV, don't cry. It will be like, call the security guards, there's a madness guy here. So there's levels, you know, it's like act as you are truly sad. So this is the main purpose of my presentation. Social engineering through improvisation. Why? We all know social engineers require a lot of reconnaissance to able to apply successful assessment or scenarios, right? In real world, social engineers are one phase of VABT project. It's very rare, at least in the Middle East, or in Dubai, the country I work, that someone is asking only for social engineer. They're asking for external pen testing, internal pen testing, and the third phase is social engineer, right? And the end, if you have a project, you should deliver it in time, right? And even if bad things happen, I mean, it's like sometimes you're doing external pen tests with the first phase, it's like take 1 month, maybe internal pen testing another month, and let's say social engineering taking 3rd month. But when running the process itself, maybe the external taking more than 1 month, maybe it's your fault or the client's fault. It's like, okay, I have a meeting, someone have authority to open this computer, pay notification, this kind of stuff. And you find yourself that social engineers have like very limited time to apply it. Assessment, or maybe you don't have time to do a lot of reconnaissance, especially for organizations have like thousands of employees. So here is common improvisation. So how? Social engineering through improvisation only increase probability of successful assessment. It doesn't mean that every time you're gonna improvise a scenario, it's work 100%, but it just increase. The probability. It's all about general knowledge. I mean, you should aware what's going on around the world. Like, for example, Donald Trump has won the presidency of USA. accidents happened inside your country and outside your country. Last news, including in your country and other world, observation. We're gonna speak about this in details. Observation is other culture, habits, traditions, signs. This is to help you when you're going to organizations that many nationalities work in it, right? You will be able, or let's say you have more powerful to exploit different people in different cultures, as you know their traditional habits. Because in the end, if you are going to establish a trust between you and the target, first thing you're gonna open a conversation between you and him, right? Last news, election, politics, accidents, new stores, new offers, new stores open in your country. Sometimes it's help. Observation. It's always attacking an old woman, not the same attacking a young man. It's totally different. What you're gonna observe? When you be inside the company, you're gonna observe the clothes, uniform type, body type, age, manners, smell, teeth, if you have cigarettes, if you have some picture of pets, of his children in the office, this kind of stuff. This is story time. Okay. For one time, I was doing external VABT and internal VABT for oil and gas company, and the third phase was social engineer assessment, right? And as usual, the project have a time. I should deliver a project list, for example, 3 months, right? Then it was the last day I finished the external pen testing, then it comes the internal one. And the internal one is to say it will finish today, and I'm gonna start the social engineer assessment. And the client is like, I have a call from the company saying, okay, the client is expecting that he wants the report maybe after 3 or 4 days, something like this, maybe less, right? And he will not ask to cover all branches or because I have like company in Dubai and Abu Dhabi and this kind of stuff. Okay, just do social engineer, get what you're able to get, and give me the report. And that day I was in the company, and by the way, the company don't have any security guards. You can just directly go to the floor. Okay, so I just have like 1 or 2 days. This is just simple, a fake account in Facebook. I don't have time to do any reconnaissance. Just someone, I pretend to be a pretty girl from Lebanon, right? And ask him to help me to get interview in this company. And he just simply gave his personal email. Not personal, sorry, company email. This another one is, I told him that I have interview, same scenario, but in the IT, please give me what application you use, you should I have read about it to be ready for the interview. And simply he did. It's like saying CCTV, I can read. Yeah, anyway, you just give me some lot of devices and applications. And here is another one. In any country, there's like, if you're aware of the knowledge, what happened in your country, what's going on, right? So every country has like mobile companies like Vodafone, Orange, this kind of companies. And just firstly, I create like a phishing page saying that's a company, blah, 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 is going to do a new offer for a data, mobile data. And simply someone click it, and he get pwned by Beef XSS. Yeah, containing the story. So I have said that the company don't have any like security guards checking who's going up and who's going out. But this is a scenario. I just after working hours, I was in the same day. By the way, the companies like have 10 floors, right? And every floor is like have a door, it's open by fingerprint. and it's like the door is open like for 10 seconds and being closed. Okay? So I just going to the elevator. I remember I was in 11th floor, something. I just go to the 12th floor. I found the door closed. I don't find anyone. Okay, then 13th floor. Yeah, I found an office boy. The office boy in this company just start cleaning up after the employees has left. So simple, I just ask him in a way that, please open that door. It's like, in a way that he's saying that I am work here or know someone here. And just he opened the door for me. This, okay. Yeah. And here's the tailgating, just going to another floor. I just, you know, spend like maybe 1 hour in the elevator going up and down, up and down, up and down. Then I just found one of the employees has opened the door and just going inside. And here is VoIP phone. I just have my laptop and put the cable of the Cisco VoIP phone and put it on my laptop. Here is the result. I am inside their network. I just simply bypass any security they have. Here is another scenario. All these scenarios has been done in 1 day, just only 1 day. I don't have any information. I just realized one of the floors, there is someone putting a cigarette in his desk, or as a smoking area in somewhere. So they told me that the smoking area is in the garage. So I went there. I just like wait for someone in this company work there and have a chat with him, right? So I applied the same scenario that I applied in a Facebook fake account. I asked him, okay, I just want to resign from my company and I want to work in this company. This company is good, is paying well salary or not. He started telling me that this company is suck. Didn't give me enough money, they treat me not well. So I just, you know, have a chit chat with him, and I convert the talk that I'm someone working in Dubai for like 10 years, I work only for 2 years, that I have a lot of connections, and he's working as, I believe, technical support. And he wants to find another job. From his talk, I realized that he's suffering from working in this company. This is a part of improvisation. And I start offering him, okay, I need your CV because I have a lot of connections, I can give you a lot of jobs. And he just simply, I just asking him, okay, what's your experience, what kind of application you work in, and he started telling me the application inside the company that he can, or he have experience on it. I'm gonna play the video. I'll show you, it's like when we get up on the floor, I take his business card and just make a video record. And as I told you, I don't have any tools, no good camera, just video captured by my personal mobile. Sound again.
You have the free version of August 2013.
Free version? No, I have the trial version.
The company used 2013. Enterprise or? You have the free version of Office 2013.
Free version? No, I have the trial version.
The company used 2013. Enterprise or?
Professional plus.
Oh, come on, I really want to use it. And what about McAfee?
McAfee? Check.
It used McAfee Enterprise what version?
It just opened the computer to tell me the version of McAfee they use.
I want to. Mm. 8.0, right?
Mm-hmm. No,
that's 8.8.
Correct me the version.
So you don't have also the free version, right?
No, personally. My business card is on the way.
What?
My business cards are on the way.
On the way?
Yeah. I was sitting in the other building for some time. So my pack of cards is there. The cards that I have here is my colleague who used to sit here before.
No problem.
So, as I told, improvisation, it's not like what is in your head, it can be applied immediately. You just have a lot of some knowledge, be aware of what's happening in your country with everything, from the political news till new shop has been open. Because knowing your country, how many like Europeans work, how many Indians work, what's their interest, what they are looking for. This is help in case that you don't have any time to do reconnaissance for applying social engineering assessment, it will help. It will help that when you're going to send a phishing mail, like for example, some culture is interesting to save money. Honestly, Indian people is very perfect in saving money. They're awesome, really. And they interesting in getting new offers, this kind of stuff. That's thing I want to learn from them. So if something happens, a new shop is opening, for example, you're gonna send a phishing mail. It's better than sending like, for example, there's a football match will be happening after 5 days. The possibility of clicking on the football news attachment is lower than a new shop has been open and giving new offers, this kind of stuff. The mitigation. So here is like a standards of how to defend yourself against social engineer. Social engineers come in several layers. The basic layer security is target employee who respond to request. Information should identify its value. Look, IDs, paper, shredding, and escorting of visitors. Then it comes a learning and security awareness. Identify what has value. Data access field, you have to be knowing what to do. Then friends are not friends. Social engineers trying to make a relation with you against to gain trust. Then passwords are personal, don't share your passwords, right? Uniforms are cheap, that social engineer will show up pretending to fix or build something. The persistent level, we have like security training against social engineer, it will be effective to increase awareness. The offensive level, that instant response if someone asks for information that you don't know, you should release and ask your manager. You shouldn't release, sorry, and ask your manager. This is the standard one. But as we know, this implementation of this security against social engineering have little bit gaps. Social engineering target everyone. It can be CEO, it can be the office boy, security guards, managers, right? So every information has a value, and it can be used for further attacks. There is no information is useless. Okay, I agree with friends not are not friends that trying to make relation to gain trust, but passwords are personal. It's beyond than someone asking you for your password. I don't think that's like someone calling you, hey, what's your password? And not giving to you. Uniforms are cheap. That's true. But social engineer, he can simply wear suit and tie. He can be a normal person. The idea is when some organization giving a security training against social engineers is like, mentions this word only. So maybe some employees understand that expecting social engineer is someone like in wearing a strange suit or something. Regular reminders is not enough. Training everyone, I mean everyone. I seen a lot of organizations like do training one time and just like keeping reminder by mail. Okay, like some tips. This is not enough. And simply, they're not training every single employee in the company. They didn't get the security guards, secretary, office boys, and put them and educating them what is social engineer really, and what the scenarios can be happened. And offensive level. What if the manager is not available? What are you gonna do? Okay, someone asked for something, I have a doubt about it, and my manager is not there. It should the company have like policy or procedures. If the manager is gonna ask someone else, or you have like some policy you're gonna follow to see if you're gonna release this information or not. In the end, didn't get paranoid, it's all about knowing your enemy well. Any questions?
He was not signaling. How do you know the difference between being a good social engineer or just having a very good company with security? So how do you demonstrate that you're a good social engineer and it's not a very good security aware company? So the difference between the two.
Oh, right, okay. So let's say if I'm gonna see if the company have a good security. It's like checking if they have a policy. They have like security awareness for everyone. I mean, you can easily ask someone, as I showed the video, and he gave you all the information, right? And simply, which you try to get, let's say, a long time or more information to target a specific one or simple one. I mean, you can simply target an organization and you successfully target one person, right? You have tried a lot of scenarios, right? And this company apply a lot of policies. They have like checking if you're going to the company itself. For example, the security guards are there, checking your ID, checking by phone. They not respond to the fake authority, this kind of stuff, right? This applying a good security. In the end, it's not saying that a company have good, very good security and social engineers target only one person, not person or two person, it's not saying he's a good or bad. It's saying that this company is good at security or not. Like if I'm like someone is good social engineer, he he will be able to target one in company and he's able to target 1,000 in this company, right? Targeting one is a good because it's high security, right? This company is targeting like 1,000. This is a low security, but in the end, he successfully target both of them.